Hello and welcome to Automation Studio How To. My name is Tobias and I will be your software geek for today. In this video, I'll be showcasing the new MapView templates and some other features in Automation Studio 6.
Let's jump right into this showcase. For this, I've created a simple project that can be found on our GitHub. There's a link in the description. So to add the new MapView templates, first, you need MapView enabled in your project. In your logical view, you can select the MapView folder and now go to over to your toolbox and press the MapView button. This will open up the templates that you can select from. There is a bunch of different sizes and orientations. So let's just select HD Landscape 1 and press Finish. It will now add it to your project as a complete and finished HMI. You can find it here. It will be called HDLS1, as in High Definition Landscape 1. Here you can find your pages with your contents and everything. So let's just try renaming a page. Let's just rename this one to Main. And maybe let's take one of these contents and call it Prod1. So if we now go to our configuration view, we can see in our MapView folder, we have our visualization file and our bindings, and they are renamed all the way through when you rename them from the logical view. So if we open our this file, we can see that the page we called main is now called main. And we can take and rename our visualization, let's call it vis, and then we go to our config and add it as a default. So let's compile and see what it looks like. So let's transfer it. So now that it is finished transferring to our simulation, we can close the transfer window and open any browser. I have it open here. So the browser, we just type localhost and go to port 81. So here we can see our complete HMI with all our bindings integrated with the user system and themes. That's all I have for you today. Remember to like and subscribe the video. And if you have any questions, please leave them for me in the comments. Have a good day.